Hello, welcome to Nuvoton's Smart Amplifier demo. In this video, we are presenting the NAU83G20 Smart Amplifier featuring Klipl's nonlinear speaker protection algorithm called Klipl's Control Sound, or KCS for short. I'm Nathan Wong, Nuvoton's application engineer and your host for this video. The objective of the video is to give a brief overview of what the KCS algorithm can accomplish, explain the audio path and components of the comparison demo, and give a description of the software associated with the demo platform. Let's get right to it. The KCS algorithm has incredible control over the speaker it was measured for. That allows the speaker to be pushed to the limit of the nonlinear region of excursion and linearizes the speaker so every frequency sounds true while suppressing all other distortions. Additionally, the smart amplifier is able to center the voice coil's position and effectively stabilize the output for consistent audio. This is the layout of the demo setup. We will be using a computer to communicate to the NAU83G20 through the Nuvoton Audio Development Board, or NAD board for short. The NAD board comes equipped with the M4 processor that uses USB to receive commands and audio data from the PC and sends it to the chip. It also comes with Nuvoton's audio enhancement algorithm called A6, which we'll be using to introduce a bass boost and flatten out the frequency response of the speaker. The full audio path of this demo starts at the PC, sending mono audio data through the USB to the M4. The M4 then processes the audio data using the A6 and introduces the bass boost and flattens out the frequency response, and then sends it through I2S to the G20 device. The G20 device then processes it through the internal DSP with Klipl's controlled sound algorithm and provides high quality output from the speaker. We capture the audio through our free field microphone 15 centimeters away from the speaker, which is then received from the input receiver and transfers that digital data to the USB to be recorded for this video. So the picture you are looking at is the physical demo setup that I have laid out. On the right, we have the hardware features of the NAU83G20, and the DC power supply I'm using is a 12-volt DC power supply. It is a mono DAC with a peak output power of 20 watts with 4 ohm. And the speaker I'm using with this is a 4-ohm speaker with a 10-watt max. With the KCS algorithm on Nuvoton Smart Amplifier, we are able to get speaker diagnostic information gathered by Klipl's DB Lab in an operation called KCS Monitor. With it, we can set the excursion limit, the thermal limit, and various other settings in the properties windows as shown here in the slide. Over here, this is the force factor BL curve in which it was taken from the measurement of the speaker on the K3. The red is actually the full measurement, while the black protruding from the center is what the excursion is going through right now. This relates to the voice coil displacement, which shows the excursion range and the voice coil center position. The excursion range of X peak and X bottom is the maximum taken within that 1 second period. The red line, which is X prot and minus X prot, is the margin which I have set in which it's 1.5 millimeters on both top and bottom, or a 3 millimeter swing. The next graph, which is on the right over here, is a voltage and current graph, which is measured across the speaker. Next, we have the voice coil temperature and electrical power right here. The voice coil temperature is the red line. We actually set the maximum for it, and it's going to be 90 degrees delta K. And delta K refers to when the measurement was done, which is at room temperature. So delta K of 90 would mean temperature limit of 110 C. The electrical power is RMS power that is dissipated across the speaker with inclusion of the speaker parameters. Next, we have the protection graph, which is right over here, and it has a mechanical protection and a thermal protection. Mechanical protection ensures that the excursion does not go over the maximum limit, which is the 3 millimeter swing, and it acts as an adaptive high pass filter. The thermal protection makes sure that the thermal limit is not reached, and as it approaches it, it sounds kind of like a broadband attenuation, which is like lowering the volume. Finally, we have the states window, which is right over here. And this is includes a button for KCS on, KCS off plus EQ, and KCS off. It gives us other textual information about temperature, excursion range, in relation to the excursion limits. We'll be focusing on the KCS on and KCS off plus EQ. I'm choosing a KCS off plus EQ as the protection system does take away some of the bass naturally as compensated by the bass boost and also increase the higher frequencies. This concludes the video introduction for the smart amplifier product as well as the software platform that Klipl provides for this smart amplifier. I'll see you in the next video.